This might be the single most life-changing question you can ask yourself. Hi, I'm James Roche, and that's the topic of today's video. The reason why this question is so life-changing is because it brings down to earth very concretely exactly why you do what you do. What is your goals and why is it important to you? Now, typically when you ask someone in business, you know, what's important to them? Why are they doing this? You get answers, things like money, or I want to have security for my family, I want to make an impact. All of these things, excellent. Great values to live by. A little abstract, right? A little conceptual. What this question does is it brings this right down to earth of exactly what is your North Star? What is it the thing that you are actually striving for practically, concretely in your life? So I'm going to give you the question in just a minute, but all I want you to do is to sit back and let all those images in your mind's eye flood into you. And then I'm going to break down the question and we're going to spend a little time looking at each part of this. So here's the question. If there were no limitation or consequences, what would your perfect average day look like? Again, if there were no limitations or consequences, what would your perfect average day look like? I don't want you to put any jail cell restrictions or any walls around your mind just flooding you with these images that you see as we talk through this question, okay? No limitations, no consequences, meaning use your own moral compass to guide what is appropriate and what's not appropriate, okay? Again, it's another form of don't limit yourself or hamper yourself in any way. And then finally, the most important part of the question really is perfect average day. Now, I'm not talking about a vacation day that you might take, a week of an entire year. No, no, no. This is your perfect average day, meaning you potentially could live this day over and over and over again, and you would be blissed out. This is your perfect average day. It's kind of like, remember that movie Groundhog Day with Bill Murray, and he had to live that same day over and over? He actually went through a form of enlightenment, a transformation. Towards the end, he really understood what was important to him and what made a difference in his life, what added meaning to his life, because he was only doing those activities that were his perfect average day. And that's what this is for you. So we got to look at not special days, but normal day that you would actually just love to live every day. So let's break this down. And again, I want you to picture things. I want you to see this as possibilities for yourself. Let's break this down into each component of a day. So imagine now for a moment, on your perfect average day, you're living it now. When you wake up, what do you see out the window? What do you see out the window on your perfect average day? Who's with you? What kind of activities do you see for yourself as you start your day? Anything in particular? What colors do you sense and what sensations do you see around you? Why is that important to you? Those activities that you're doing in the first beginnings of your perfect average day, why is that important to you? Then you start your day. You start your activities for your day. What happens? What do you see yourself doing? What kind of, maybe you're doing work. Maybe you're spending time with people. What is it for you? Then let's look at the middle of the day here. We're talking around noontime, around lunchtime. Where do you see yourself on your perfect average day having lunch? Again, when you look out the window, what do you see? What kind of environment are you in? Who are you with? Also, in this day, what kind of conversations are you having? What's the topic, the theme of these conversations typically? This is very important. Like, what do you like to spend your energy on in conversation with other people? And who are these other people? Again, let these images flood in for yourself right now. Now we move to the second half of the day. What do you see yourself doing there? What kind of activities are there? Same thing. As we move into the evening, who are you with? What kind of environments around you? Why are those particular images important to you? Think about that for a second. And what kinds of topics and themes are coming up again in your conversations with people? What kind of activities are you doing that just light you up, that give you so much joy and give your life so much meaning? What are those specifically? And as you're rounding out the day, what do you see yourself doing there? What kind of activities are you doing? Who are you with? Now, I'm sure you're starting to see those images actually right now. What I want you to do is over the next 24 hours, let those images continue to flood into your mind's eye and really absorb what you're seeing, again, with no limitations or feeling of consequences that you have to restrict yourself. Let it simmer over the next 24 hours. And if you like, you can also build a vision board based on the images that you see, because again, this is the concrete, real life, how you want your life and your lifestyle to look like. Not as some abstract values, but as real life activities and experiences that have real meaning for you. So I'll share with you a little bit about my experience with this question. About 10 years ago, I always had in my mind's eye, I just saw myself working at a European cafe, and I always saw myself through the window, looking outside into the window, and there I was sitting on a nice old table, working on my laptop, creating things, because that's what I love to do. I like to build things and design things and create things. And I saw myself with a lovely cappuccino and a croissant. And I always, this was 10 years ago, I always saw myself with somebody. I was single at the time, but I had imagination that there was someone who I loved dearly who was there with me. And I actually made a vision board of these experiences that I imagined in my mind's eye. I found images, put it on a vision board, and made that vision board for myself about 10 years ago. Fast forward to now, and actually those elements of those perfect ideal day are actually what I experience almost every day of my life right now. I consciously designed my life to match what I saw in my mind's eye at that time. And I am married now with my lovely wife, and right out the window here to my right is Amsterdam. We live in Amsterdam now, and I bicycle all the time. We go every weekend, we go for bike rides in the countryside. Virtually every day I'm going to a cafe or an office space that I use. I'm having my cappuccino and my croissant, and it is exactly as I always envision myself. In the evenings, I'm going to the concert hall, or we're spending time hanging out with friends. So this isn't just, again, some sort of abstract exercise. This is your template in which you design your lifestyle on. So again, I really invite you over the next 24 hours to flesh those pictures out even further and let that be your North Star, your anchor point in actually designing your lifestyle from those meaningful images that you see. And again, I want you to comment below, share with us some of the ideas you have already starting to flood in, and give us also a sense of how this exercise, how you're starting to see it impacting your life even right now as you're hearing it for the first time. All right, well, this is James Roche signing off. Thank you so much, and enjoy this wonderful, wonderful, life-changing question.